Female genital mutilation, or FGM, is a practice of removing part or all of the female external genitalia for non-medical reasons. It is often carried out as a coming-of-age ritual for girls. According to the World Health Organization, 200 million women have undergone FGM in 31 countries, including countries in Africa and the Middle East. About 3.5 million women a year, or an average of 9,800 women a day, are on the verge of death. According to UNICEF data, the prevalence of FGM among girls and women aged 15 to 49 years in the countries with the highest prevalence is as follows. Somalia, 98%. Guinea, 97%. Djibouti, 93%. Sierra Leone, 90%.
Mali, 89%.
Egypt and Sudan, 87% each.
Well, first of all, you have to have a right. You have to have your own right and own decision in life to make such a decision, you know. But in when it comes to FGM, it's a child abuse, pure child abuse. A little 2 years old child is being mutilated, and it's okay to accept this. Child abuse is child abuse, no matter where it is. And it needs to be addressed and stopped immediately.
In countries where FGM is prevalent, women who have not undergone FGM are believed to be not clean. So the female genitals are removed and then stitched up as proof of being a virgin. Then on the first night after marriage, the husband pulls out the thread with a knife or blade. Women who have not undergone FGM cannot get married. They are banished from the village and treated like prostitutes. By 2050, one-third of the world's female population will be born in Africa and the Middle East. More than 500 million women are at the risk of undergoing FGM. FGM needs your interest now.